Hello viewers, our today's topic of discussion is function. As you know, what is function? A function is a relation in which no two ordered pairs can have the same first component. That is, if I make a relation from set A to set B, you cannot choose two ordered pairs which have same first component. For example, let capital A and capital B be two non-empty sets. Not necessarily they are distinct, they may be equal. If a function, if a relation is made from A to B such that F is subset of A cross B, by which we can associate each and every element of set A to one and only one element of set B, then this relation is called a function or a mapping from set A to set B. That is, the elements of set A will have only one image in set B. For example, let this is your set A, this is your set B. If we can define a relation from set A to set B such that each and every element of set A has an one and only one image in set B, then it is called a function from set A to set B. The set A is called the domain and set B is called the codomain of the function f. Okay. So, what is function? A function is a relation in which no two ordered pairs have the same first component. Okay. That is, for two non-empty sets, if by the relation f, which is subset of A cross B, if we can associate each and every member of set A to one and only one member of set B, then the relation is called a function from set A to set B, and the set A is called domain and set B is called codomain. Okay. Okay. Now, for class 12, the topic of functions are types of function. Okay. There are four basic types. Number one is one-one, number two is many-one, number two is on, three is onto, and number four will be into function. First, it is one-one function. This is number one. One-one function. A function f is such that A tends to B is said to be 1-1 if each and every element of set A have a unique image in set B. That is, each and every element of set A has a unique image in set B. If I suppose this is your set A, the domain, this is your set B, the codomain, and if I place a mirror here, then this is your set of image, this is your set of pre-image. If we can define a function in such a way that each and every element of set A have a unique image in set B, then this function is called a one-one function. For example, if I have these elements in set A, capital B, if I can define a function from A to B in such a way that each and every element of set A has a unique image in set B. That is, no two elements of set A has a same image in set B, then it is called a one-one function. Okay. For example, if I define a function f of x is equal to x square from natural number to natural number, from n to n, in this case, if I put x equal to 1, I will get 1. For x equal to 2, I will get 2 square. For x equal to 3, I get 3 square. That is, for all different x, we are getting different y. That is, every x has a unique image in f. So, it is a one-one function. Okay. Now, what is many-one function? Now, many-one function is if there exists at least one element in set B which has more than one pre-image in set A, it is called a many-one function. We can define a many-one function like this. Number 2 is many-one function. A function f is such that A tends to B is said to be a many-one function if there exists at least one element in B which have more than one pre-image just in set A. That is, for two different elements of set A, the function have same image in set B. So, it is called a many-one function. For example, if you say f of x is equal to x square, if I define from real number to real number, that is from real number to real number, if I put x equal to 1, it is 1 square, it is 1. For x equal to minus 1, it is again minus 1 square, it is again 1. So, for two different x, the function has similar image. So, it is a many-one function. Now, how to check one-oneness or many-oneness? How to check a function is whether one-one or it is many-one? Now, there are three different methods. We will try to see these methods. Number one, it is called analytical method. Analytical method. Okay. Let x1 comma x2 belongs to A. Let there exist two elements in set A. That is, there x1, x2 belongs to set A, and we also assume that f of x1 is equal to f of x2. That is, we assume that the function have same image in set B for the elements x1 and x2. Now, if we can show that x1 is equal to x2, that is, they have equal image when they coincide. If you can show that x1 is equal to x2, then we can say the function is 1 1. That is, the function having similar image for x1 and x2 as they are equal, that is, they coincide. In this case, we call it a 1 1 function. We call it a 1 1 function. Otherwise, when x1 not equal to x2, we call it many-one function. That is, for two different x, the function has same image. Okay, this is your analytical method. Okay, number two, this is by calculus. In calculus, a function is called strictly increasing or strictly decreasing when f dash x, that is, the derivative of function is always positive or negative. For example, if I say f dash x is positive, function is strictly increasing, and for f dash x is less than 0, function is strictly decreasing. Now, for 1-1 function, the function will be either strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. If I draw the graphs of some 1-1 function, it will be like this. For example, f of x is equal to x cube. The graph of x cube is like this. For x positive, this is positive. For x negative, this is negative. The graph of x cube is a strictly increasing function. When x increases, the value of the function also increases. This is a strictly increasing function. If I draw the tangent at any point of this graph, it will have a slope which is positive. That is, f dash x will be greater than 0. Okay. Now, what about log function? This is your graph of log x. Now, tangent at any point of this graph y equal to log x or f of x is equal to log of x, the tangent will have always a positive slope. That is, for one-one function, the value of f dash x will be either greater than equal to 0 or either less than 0. That is, if the function is strictly increasing or strictly decreasing, then it is a one-one function. For many one function, for example, if I say f of x is equal to x cube, x square, for many one function, the function will be neither increasing nor decreasing. In this case, your function is y equal to x square. From minus infinity to 0, the function is decreasing, and from 0 to infinity, function is increasing. So, this function is neither increasing or not decreasing. So, it is an example of many one function. For one one function, the function will be always strictly increasing or strictly decreasing. Okay. And for many one function, it neither increases nor decreases. Okay. This is the example of many one function and one one function. Now, how to use calculus in case of these functions? For example, f of x is equal to x plus sin x. You cannot use analytical method in these cases. For entrance purpose, we use calculus method. Now, for this kind of function, f of x is equal to x plus sin x, you cannot use analytical method. If I let x1 and x2 belongs to capital A or the domain, and you put x1 equal to x2, then you equal the values, you cannot find, you cannot solve these things, because it is algebraic plus trigonometric. You cannot solve the equations. So, how to find it is whether it is 1-1 or 1-2? If I differentiate this function f dash x, it will be is equal to 1 plus cos x. For sin x, the derivative is cos x, and for x, derivative is 1. Now, what is 1 plus cos x? This is equal to twice cos squared x by 2. Now, 1 plus cos twice has a formula, twice cos squared a by 2. So, it is 2 cos squared x by 2. Now, this is 2 times cos squared. What is cos squared? Always positive. Therefore, the value of this will be always greater than equal to 0. Now, I can assume this is always positive. That is, the function f dash x is always positive. That is, fx strictly increases. Therefore, the function will be a 1-1 function. If I draw its graph, its graph will be like this. For x equal to 0, x 0, sin 0 is 0. This is 0. For x equal to pi, pi plus 0, sin pi is 0. So, it will be pi comma pi. For x equal to pi by 2, the value will be pi by 2 plus 1. The graph will be like this. This is your y equal to x line. The graph of this function will be like this. Now, if you draw tangent at any point on this graph, will be always positive. So, it is a 1-1 function, because it is always strictly increases. It's example of 1-1 function. We can use calculus in these types of functions, where we cannot use analytical process easily. Now, there is a third process which is called graphical method. Graphical method number 3, this is called graphical method. In graphical method, if we draw a line parallel to the x-axis and it intersects the function at more than one point, it is a many one function. That is, for two different x, we are getting similar y. For example, this is a function. If I draw a line parallel to x-axis Now, this function is intersected at more than one point by the line y is equal to k. This is the line parallel to x axis for any constant k. Now, the function has similar y, but for different x. This is your x1, this is your x2. Therefore, for two different x, the function has similar y. Therefore, it is example of many one function. For one one function, the line parallel to x axis will intersect the function at only one point or maybe at no point. This is a graphical method. These are one one and on many one functions. Okay. Now, your third case is, third function is onto function. A function f such that a tends to b is said to be an onto function if each and every element of B is associated, or you can say each and every element of B have at least one image in set A. That is, the entire B participate in range formation. That is, all the elements of set B have a at least one image in set B. That is, entire B participates in range formation of the function. What is range? Range is the set of elements of set B which are associated with at least one element of set A under the function f is called a range. Now, if each and every element of set B have at least one image in set A, it is called a onto function. Onto function, that is, the range of the function, the range of the function is equal to codomain. Range equal to codomain, that is, the entire codomain participates in range formation. And here comes your fourth function. This is called into function. What is into function? Number 4 is into function. A function f is such that a tends to b is said to be an into function if there exists at least one element in B which have no image, no pre-image in set A. That is, at least one element of set B has no pre-image in set A. That is, there exists at least one element in set B which does not participate in range formation. That is, the set B, entire set B is not equal to range of the function. That is, range of the function, range of f is subset of codomain. That is, range will be subset of codomain. That is, an entire set B does not participate in range formation. This is your into function. Now, based on these four functions, that is, one one, many one, onto and into, we can classify in four other functions too. Number one will be one one onto, number two will be one one into, number three will be many one onto, and number four will be many one onto. For into, number one is one one onto. I will try to show the mapping. This is your set A, this is your set B. What is 1-1 function?
1-1 means each and every element of set A has a unique image in set B. It is called a 1-1 function. And what is 1-2 function? When the entire set B participates in range formation. That is, each and every element of set B has a pre-image in set A. This is your set of images, this set of pre-images.
Now, if I take some elements in set A like this, this is your set B. See, this is an example of 1-1 and 1-2 function. See, each and every element of set A has a unique image in set B, and each and every element of set B has a pre-image in set A. That is, entire B participates in range formation. It is an example of 1-1-1-2 function. 1-1-2 function. If I draw the mapping from A to B, this is your set of images, this set of pre-images. This is called 1-1-1-2. Now, your second case will be 1-1-into. Now, 1-1-into means each and every element of set A has a unique image in set B, but there exists at least one element in set B which has no pre-image in set A. For example, if I draw the mapping like this, this set A, this set B. There exists some elements in set A, some elements are there in set B also. Now, every element of set A has a unique image in set B, but there exists at least one. See, there exists at least one element in set B which has no pre-image in set A. That is, these two elements does not participate in range formation. So, it is an example of 1-1 and into function. Here range will be subset of codomain. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements participate in range formation. So, entire B is not equal to range. So, range is a subset of codomain. This is an example of 1-1 into function. Now, number 3. Number 3 will be many 1 onto. What is many 1 function? If there exists at least one element in set B which has more than one pre-image in set A, it is called a many one function. So, if I write like this, this is many one onto. I can draw the mapping of this function like this. This is set A, this is set B. Let's take some elements in set A. These are some elements in set B. Now, do the mapping like this. See, each and every element of set B has a pre-image in set A. That is, entire B participates in range formation, and there exists an element in set B which has more than one pre-image in set A. So, it is an example of many one and onto function. So, range will be is equal to codomain, and set B has a element which has more than one pre-image. This is your first pre-image, this is your second pre-image, which have similar image in set B. So, it is an example of many one onto function. And your fourth one will be many one into function. How to check a function is whether onto or not? If you can find the range of the function, and if I equate to its codomain, if the value of range is equal to codomain, that is, the function is onto, and if the range of the function is subset of codomain, it is called an into function. Now, many one into function for two sets capital A and two sets capital B. If I choose some elements of set A and set B in such a way that, see, I am drawing some mapping. See, there exists at least one element in set B which has no preimage in set A. That is, this element does not participate in range formation. So, range will be subset of codomain, and each and every element of set A has a image in set B, but there exists an element capital in capital B which has more than one preimages. So, it is an example of many one function. So, these are the four classifications we can make depending upon the types of function. First, it is a one-one function, that is many-one function, then it is onto function, then it is into function. Now, depending upon this classification, we can say there are four other types of functions. One is one-one onto, then one-one into, many-one onto, and many-one into. For one-one function, for every x, there will be unique y in the range. And for many-one function, there exists some y for which we have two different x in the domain. And what is your onto function? For onto function, the range will be equal to codomain, that is entire codomain participates in range formation. And for into function, there exists at least some element in set B which has no preimage in set A, that is the entire set B, it is a codomain, does not participate in range formation. Okay, so we know how to find this one one, it is onto and into.